हेलो, गुड आफ्टरनून ऑल ऑफ यू। आई एम शेखर शर्मा, अगेन विद यू फॉर क्लास सेवेंथ मैथमेटिक्स चैप्टर 8, कमर्शियल मैथमेटिक्स पार्ट 2। लेट्स स्टार्ट विद एक्सरसाइज 8.1। 10 मैन कैन डिग अ वेल इन 9 डेज। इन हाउ मैनी डेज कैन 15 मैन डिग द सेम वेल। This question is based on unitary method. Now look at this carefully. 10 men can dig a well in 9 days. One man can dig a well in more days or less days? More days. When days are more, then it would be multiplied. 15 men can dig a well in days would be less or more? Less. Now it would be divide. Now let's calculate it. 3 3 is a 9 and 3 5 is a 15 and 5 2 is a 10. 3 2 is a 6 days. That would be your answer. We have to understand it very carefully. There are two methods of unitary method: direct variation or inverse variation. Now, second question: a bag containing 30 apple weighs 6 kilogram. How much will be 180 such apple weigh? Means what is the weight of 180 apples? So let's start. Now let's start with this. Weight of 30 apple is 6 kg. So weight of one apple would be more or less? It would be less. Less means it would be divide. Then weight of 1080 apples, it would be less or more? It would be more. Then it would be multiplied. It is 30. 6 5 is 30. And when 1080 is divided by 5, it is now down 1, kg. First question was of inverse variation, and this fourth question from your book is of direct variation. Now, 8th question from your book. A man work 8 hours daily and complete a task in 12 days. If he work 6 hours daily, in how many days will the same work be completed? So let's start. A man completes the task in days. If he work 8 hours daily, then in 12 days. If he work 1 hour daily, so in less days or more days? More days. So 12 multiply 8 days. And if he work 6 hours daily, then less days according to 1. 12 multiply 8 upon 6. 6 to the 12 and 8 to the 16 days. The work will be finished in 16 days if he is working 6 hours daily. Hello, good afternoon all of you. I am Shekhar Sharma, again with you for class 7th mathematics chapter 8, commercial mathematics part 3. Some questions from exercise 8.2 and 8.3 will be solved in this video. Express as percentage. 3 upon 4. 3 upon 4 multiplied by 100 and percentage. 4. When we divide 100 by 4, we get 25. 3 multiply 25 and it is 75%. Express as percent, same as 1 upon 2, oh sorry, 1 ratio 2. So 1 ratio 2 is written as 1 upon 2, and again same method applied. It is 50, so 50%. Now again convert in fraction at first. 0.02 equal 2 upon 100. Converted in percentage with same method, 100 divided by 100, 2%. Okay, now express as fraction. So 26% equal 26 upon 100. The SF 2 is there, so it is 13 and it is 50. 13 upon 50 is the answer. If it is written in ratio, so 13 ratio 50 if it is asked. Express as ratio in simplest form. Let me write a question. So here's the question. 1.2%. For that, at first 1.2 is written as 12 upon 10, then percent. 12 upon 10 multiply by 100, 12 upon 1000. SCF in this is 4. 4 threes are 12 and 4 250. 3 ratio 200. 50. Now exercise 8.3, profit and loss. Some formulas are profit SP minus CP, profit percent, profit upon CP multiplied by 100, loss CP minus SP, loss percent, loss upon CP multiplied by 100. Let's start. Exercise 8.3. Find the SP. Formula is SP equal CP plus profit 250 plus 22, 272 would be the SP. Find CP. CP equal SP minus profit 400 minus 35, that would be 365. So let CP equal rupees X, then gain percent, gain upon CP multiply by 100, gain would be 10% of CP, hence it is profit percent. 10% of X ten upon 100, 10x, it is cut, that would be X upon 10 SP equal CP plus profit. CP is X and it is X upon 10 13 20, 11x upon 10 equal 13 20, x equal 13 20 upon 11. It would be divide 11 into 11, 11 2 are, and that is 1200 rupees. Thank you. Have a nice day.